Welcome, everyone, to NBA Basketball on 2K Sports. With Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg, I'm Brian Anderson. Allie LaForce is our reporter. Allie, it's all yours.
Well, Anthony Davis grew up in Chicago during the Jordan years, so is that why he wears number 23? He said, quote, "I wore number 3 in grade school. In high school, I asked for that number. Coach said, you'll get whatever I give you out of this bag. He grabbed out a jersey and threw it to me, and it was number 23. Guys, AD said, that'll work.
No doubt. Good stuff, Allie. Thanks. All right, let's take a look at New Orleans' starting lineup. Ingram and Zion, the former Dukies, in at forward. McCollum and Jones, the tandem in the backcourt. And it's Valanciunas in at the center position, locking down the middle. And for the Lakers, LeBron is the 4 with Davis at the 5 as they go small. Russell Westbrook out there with Patrick Beverley. And it's Walker in at the small forward position. It's early in the season, but we're already seeing some teams fall short of expectations. Grant, what do these teams need to do to get back on track?
Well, first of all, they have to relax. They can't panic. It's still early in the season. But, of course, it's on the leaders of each team to set the tone. They need to make sure everyone is locked in and on the same page.
Here's New Orleans now. Williamson passes to McCollum. From the line. Yep, that one goes.
Yeah, the craftiness of McCollum. Smooth in that mid-range area.
James, outside. Beverly outside. Pass to Davis. Nice D from Valanciunas. And he lobs it up. And Williamson throws it down.
Outstanding decision making by Ingram there. Working it to the open man. Really good possession.
And now just over a minute played here in the first. They need something good to happen here.
Yeah, they've gone way too long without a score.
Westbrook, the pass to James. Shot from the top of the key. Valanciunas with a rebound.
Almost too wide open there. That's like a warm-up jumper for him.
Outside Ingram. Pass to McCollum. Back to Ingram. Clock at 6. He's now 1 for 2 with that bucket.
Well, you know, Ingram's length is really an asset inside. It allows him to work over and around defenders.
The Lakers have gone 0-for-3 from the floor to begin this one.
And just one of the most impressive titles in league history, guys. The 2020 Lakers winning it all in the Orlando bubble. A testament to LeBron James and that team.
You know, that 2020 bubble title for the Lakers. What made it so difficult?
You know, B.A., the mental grind of all that time in the bubble. 3 months in the same place. NBA players are used to being in 4 cities in a week.
Shooting
so
two.
It really was a different kind of challenge for them.
And the first one at the line is good.
You know, with that combination of strength and length, Davis can easily overwhelm defenders and get himself to the foul line.
Both free throws good from Davis. And Anthony Davis on the NBA's top 75 list. Grant, you think that was a controversial selection?
Well, I mean, it was mostly due to how young Davis still is. You can't argue with the all-NBA selection and numbers. And, of course, being a recent champion may have put him over the top. They've hit 4 of their first 5 shots. Great execution and attention to detail.
And that's good. His first bucket of the game.
Westbrook has really honed his ball handling skills, so now he's able to create very well off the dribble.
Fantastic replay we just saw of the mobile one drive.
You're toasting the defense and getting in close. They'll take possessions like that one all day.
Pass to Valanciunas. And here's Ingram. Valanciunas with a screen on Walker. 6 on the shot clock. It's a 3-on-3 fast break. Here's James. Kicks it out to Westbrook. Davis with a screen on Jones. Beverly, the pass to Davis, to the wing, right side. The Lakers got to get one up, late clock.
And I tell you what, AD is able to brush off those defenders with ease because of how strong he is. That's what they call weight room.
Here's Jones. Pass to McCollum, launches it. Rebounded by the Lakers. They're coming off a win against the Nuggets.
Yeah, they hit the court last game with some serious attitude, especially on offense.
And, you know, confidence is key there. They seem to play with a ton of it, especially on the offensive end.
Gotta fight harder to get over those screens.
Well, I'm gonna credit the screen. I mean, that's a good, strong pick he lays there.
Shot's good by McCollum.
This is just fun. These teams are trading threes back and forth.
Nothing like answering back. One team gets three, you fire three of your own. Boom.
Westbrook with the miss.
Boy, he's much better than that. Really no excuse for missing that lay-in.
Ingram finds Williamson. The basket drops, and he gets fouled on the shot. One free throw coming his way.
You know, coach gets mad when Williamson gets hit and there's no whistle, and it happens a lot.
Good from Williamson. Here's Westbrook in the game against Denver. Very impressive. James outside. And Davis slams it home.
Boy, there's not a better target in all of the NBA than Davis for the alley-oop.
New Orleans in the lead. McCollum with it. He's got five. Shoots over Westbrook. McCollum's shot is off. The Lakers have gone 4 of 9 in this one so far. Here's Walker. And he's going to the line for two. The official saw contact while he was going up. It's going to be on Brandon Ingram.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
And he makes a first. The Pelicans making a switch here. Hayes is checked in. Both shots good from the stripe. So it's the Pelicans now. Their last game, a win against the Clippers, looking to carry it into this one.
And it's just so hard to stop them when they're scoring at that level. They were efficient and didn't let up at all.
Well, it's really hard to stop them when they're in a groove offensively, and they were in a comfort zone all game long in that one.
Now Beverly. Pass to Davis. James outside. It's deflected. Williamson passes to Jones. Back to Williamson. Pelicans get another bucket right there.
The big story thus far, how well they've shot the rock.
Very high percentage so far, and if you want to start a game hot, that's the way to do it.
And as Westbrook gets older, he's indicated that he's not looking to change how he plays, Grant.
And that can be a double-edged sword, B.A. You love his aggression and confidence, but you wonder how his game will hold up as his athleticism goes.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
First one falls.
Known for racking up triple-doubles, Westbrook continues to pile up incredible numbers. I mean, his intensity on a nightly basis is absolutely insane.
And so Westbrook nails both of them. New Orleans has gone 2 for 3 from outside the arc. Pass to Murphy. Here's Daniels. Nance the screen. On the take. Always a nice way to start. Makes his first one.
And, you know, coaches will take possessions like that all day long. Phenomenal use of the screen there.
Nunn, the pass to Westbrook. There's a screen. The kick out to Nunn. Fires for 3. That's good. And so Westbrook with the assist.
Yep, Westbrook seems to have a sixth sense for those kinds of openings. Knows exactly where the gap is and finds his teammate perfectly.
Pass to Hayes. Here's Daniels. And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Yeah, really left him no choice there. I mean, he had to foul and keep him from converting the easy bucket.
All right, guys, let's get your take on the scoring breakdown for the Pelicans.
They've done a great job establishing an inside presence. Now, that'll open up more options offensively throughout the remainder of the game.
They've also displayed a real unselfishness as a team, moving the basketball well, sharing the rock, and giving everybody a chance to participate in the offense.
That one misses.
Yeah, and it's still early, but missing free throws is something to keep an eye on.
Yeah, and as a coaching staff, you feel helpless here. I mean, there's nothing you can do about it. You just hope they snap out of the rut.
Reeves has checked in for the Lakers. And he can't make the second free throw either. He missed them both.
And an absolute brutal showing from the line so far.
And they need every point they can muster right now. They've got to cash in here.
Back to Brown. Right side, Nunn. Gabriel. And the dunk to finish it off. A beauty.
B.A., the one-hand dunk just looks so fluid.
Yeah, absolutely. Even smooth when he's powering it home like that.
Part of what makes him unique, guys, that combination of power and polish.
And so it's New Orleans with it, following the score by the Lakers.
And they ended up in the top 10 in shooting percentage, a nice place to be. They did a nice job of running their offense.
And they really loved to push the ball, finishing in the top 5 in fast break points. They were a fun team to watch. The first free throw is good. He's perfect from the line this time. 1:19 left to play in the first. Pass to Gabriel. Shot clock at 6. Here's Toscano Anderson. And again, it's the Lakers.
And I love it. Challenging the bigger defender and showing plenty of heart.
Well, the size mismatch is no problem for this fella, guys. I mean, how much do you like seeing that aggressiveness from him?
Here's Alvarado. Boy, no scoring yet from him, but that's likely to change. Pass to Hayes. Here's Daniels. There's the block. The Lakers trail. We've got a 9-second difference between the shot clock and game clock. Here's Reeves. They grab their own miss. And that one's good. Gabriel.
They're not messing around. 5 of their last 6 buckets have come from the interior.
Here's Alvarado. Nunn defends. Here's Alvarado. And the shot goes.
They keep trading punches. Both teams in a groove early.
Hey, guys, this is going to be fun now. I mean, we've got ourselves a shootout on tap here.
A nice first quarter of play. We've seen plenty of offense so far. Pelicans ahead, up by 1. And back in a moment as we'll get underway with quarter number 2. Close game underway so far. We'll see if either of these teams can jump out ahead in this second quarter. And guys, what's your take on the Pelicans so far?
They're off to a rock-solid start. They brought a well-thought-out plan into this one.
Yeah, you know what? Makes it really easy for the coaching staff in that case. No adjustments needed. Just keep on keeping on.
And legacies are defined in the playoffs. Game to game, what's the measure of greatness for a star player in your mind, Grant?
Well, B.A., I think it's all about consistency. The great ones in this league historically bring it every night. They may have a bad game here or there, but for the most part, the energy, the effort, and the consistency is always there.
LeBron is the 4 with Davis at the 5 as they go small. Patrick Beverley out there with Russell Westbrook. And it's Toscano Anderson in at the 3, the small forward. That's the group for the Lakers to kick off the second quarter. Left side, Davis. Nice D from Valanciunas. The Pelicans trail. Here's McCollum. Again, the Pelicans good for 2.
Put your head down and go to work. That's what they need to do.
Yeah, these teams trading punches right now. I mean, it's table tennis. Back and forth we go.
Pass to Toscano Anderson.
Oh, there's the alley!
Ingram, the pass to Jones.
Dunk and a foul! A powerhouse move! He's got a chance for one more at the line.
It's going to be on Anthony Davis. Walker, he's checked in for Toscano Anderson. Free throw off from Jones. And for the Lakers, they're shooting efficiently, 50% so far. Jones against Walker. Pass to Davis. Westbrook with it. That's in there! Davis with the assist. Westbrook's got 6.
The defense all over Westbrook there, but he's crafty. He's slick, and he was focused on that shot.
We're about 1.5 minutes into the second quarter. Outside Ingram. And here is Williamson. He had a 21-point outing in their last game against the Clippers in Los Angeles.
Boy, I thought his passing was absolutely fantastic. I mean, really picked apart the defense all game long.
Davis against Jones. Basket counts. Give him 8 points now.
And force feeding the ball inside. I mean, no reason to go away from what's working.
And when you make 5 in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
McCollum, the pass to Williamson. Now here's Ingram. He's got 7. Going inside. And there's Williamson on the assist by Ingram. Ingram's got his 4th assist in this one. Quarter 2 and just under 2.5 minutes gone by. And when Pelicans fans watch what Ingram has become, It takes the sting out of the Anthony Davis trade, Grant.
Yeah, I mean, Ingram has grown into a full-fledged star in New Orleans. I mean, he's a centerpiece for the franchise going forward. Now, looking back, it seems like it was a win-win trade for both teams.
The Pelicans have gone 3 of 5 since the beginning of the second. Here's McCollum. That shot off.
He's certainly been cold this quarter, guys, but trying to shoot his way back into a groove.
Davis can't hit. Now, for those joining us now, we're in the second quarter, about 3 minutes gone by. McCollum against Westbrook. McCollum, the pass to Jones. Just 5 to shoot. Williamson with a screen on Beverly. The ball's knocked loose. And it goes out of bounds. Last touch by Williamson. Graham's checked in for McCollum. The Lakers in the lead. Westbrook left side. And Davis slams it home.
Beautiful setup on the alley-oop.
Great catch, great flush.
Boy, I tell you what, that's the play we'll remember if they can put together a little surge to break this game open.
The Pelicans' shooting continues to impress. 65% from the field. Here's Ingram. And a slam dunk by Ingram.
Ingram clearly on the attack there, not allowing the defense to do anything with that dunk.
The Lakers have gotten 5 of 7 shots to go in the second. Pass to James. To the inside. And Beverly gets it to go. Hey, Beverly's got 4 points now in the quarter.
I tell you what, it reminds me of one of my college coaches. He used to say, that ain't gonna get it done. That's 5 straight baskets in the paint now.
Here's Williamson. Doesn't go for him. And the Lakers will go the other way with it. Their first chance this season playing the Pelicans.
Yes, the first of 4 meetings between the teams. They should be quite familiar with one another by the end of it.
You know what, guys? I don't know. I get the feeling that this could be an interesting matchup this season. This first game will tell us a lot.
To the paint. And Williamson throws it down.
Did you guys feel that? When Zion slams it, the floor shakes.
The Lakers have gotten 6 of 9 attempts to go in the second. Looking good. Westbrook against Graham. Westbrook, that's good. Westbrook's got his 3rd bucket of the night.
I think the defense gave him a bit of a gift there. I mean, he got all the space he needed to go to work.
Graham with it. Now quiet so far offensively, searching for his 1st points of the game. Pass to Ingram. Rebounded by LeBron. For Los Angeles, they've gotten 7 of 10 attempts to drop in the second quarter. Davis a screen. Here's the 3. And that one's good. James. And now a 6-point Los Angeles lead. Outside Graham. Williamson right side. Pass to Ingram. Shot clock at 5. Over Walker. Davis with a rebound.
Clean look from mid-range. Coach will probably want to run that play again.
Westbrook outside. Davis with a screen on Graham. Westbrook, the pass to Davis. And finished off by Davis.
When Davis gets going like this, there's no way you can stop him, giving you his entire package right now.
And New Orleans shooting 45% here in the second. They're searching for a way to score.
Yeah, buckets have been very tough to come by.
And the Pelicans call time here. And it's a completely new group for the Lakers.
Third and second chance points. And they caused a lot of headaches with their on-ball defense. They cracked the top 10 in team steals. More than a few games changed because of their aggressive D.
And what saved them in a lot of games, the second chance points. They were relentless on the offensive glass. A minute 50 left to play in the second quarter. Here's Graham. There's the drive. Pass to Hayes. Here's Daniels. Six to shoot. Good on the shot. He has six.
And they had early success from the perimeter, but I don't understand how they've gotten away from that here in the second.
And trailing in this game, now is not the time to start playing conservatively. I mean, if you've got an open look from deep, let it go. I mean, you've got to play freely and with confidence.
Outside Nunn. Pass to Reeves. Outside Brown. Launches a three. And they get it back. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans. Here's Murphy. He picked up 15 in their last win against the Clippers in Los Angeles. Nance the screen. Here's Graham. Here's Nance. Plenty of space. No good off the back of the rim. Los Angeles has gone one of two from deep in the second quarter. Now Nunn. Pass to Toscano-Anderson. Here's Reeves. He can't get that one to fall. Nice D from Nance. The Pelicans trail.
And they can run out the clock here. No need to rush it.
Yeah, don't give them another possession here.
And here is Graham. It's tipped. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers with a six-point lead at the close of the quarter. And it's all due to their ability to own the paint. They've been dominant down low. And don't go far. We'll be right back.
Welcome, one and all. Before we hear Kenny and Shaq's insights on that first half, let's look ahead and check out the upcoming schedule.
A bunch of tough games on the road. They'll learn a lot about their team. Who steps up during this stretch and who can't handle?
A challenging upcoming schedule for these guys, no doubt. And we come back to the game at hand in the first half. Plenty to like for the Lakers.
I love how they've been moving that rock on this one, making the extra pass whenever they can, going from a good shot to a great one.
That's the winning approach, winning basketball.
Thanks, as always, for watching. Let's head back to Brian Anderson and crew for the start of the second half.
We've got second half action for you, and if the next couple of quarters are similar to the first, this one could go down to the last possession. A fantastic game from Anthony Davis in this one.
And in the first half, he dominated in the post. He got the looks he wanted and was able to execute.
Yeah, you know what? I think he's doing exactly what he has to do, using his body, shaking off contact, and then finishing at the rim.
And we're halfway through this one. Plenty of basketball left in a game that's been a fairly even one. Los Angeles has gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. Second half underway. Here's who Willie Green's got on the floor. Zion and Valanciunas playing up front. Jones and Ingram run the wings, and it's McCollum at the point.
You know, with AD's improved court awareness, when guys on his team get open, he'll find them.
Westbrook's gone 4 of 5 shooting from the field. McCollum against Westbrook. Valanciunas with a screen on Walker. Here's Ingram. Davis with a rebound. Davis has got his fourth rebound in this one.
And they're doing strong work on the glass. A plus 5 advantage for them.
And guys, you know that rebounding is a huge part a huge component of winning games. It's not a glamour stat, but it's necessary if you're going to be a winning team.
That was another look at our Mobile One drive of the game just a moment ago.
Yeah, and with a finish like that, you know he's looking to extend the lead and put this game out of reach.
Shots good by McCollum.
Not only a perimeter player, McCollum can go inside.
Pass to Davis. Shoots over Valanciunas, and Davis gets it to go on the assist from James. Davis has got 14.
And another great assist. The offense is really clicking now.
You know, the defense has really been kept off balance because of the outstanding passes. Four straight field goals have been made off an assist.
Here's Ingram. Oh, and there's the whistle on the shot. So two free throws for him coming up.
An aggressive move that time by Ingram, putting up the shot while absorbing the foul.
Shooting two.
First one falls for him.
You know, Ingram is quiet about the work he puts in after practice and before games. This is a guy who just never stops trying to improve, though, and that's shown up in how he's grown as a player.
Both free throws good from Ingram.
Making it look effortless. Send this guy to the stripe, he's going to cash in more than not.
Westbrook outside to the middle. Ooh, the lead pass was in the perfect spot to set up the layup. 16 points for him.
And you know Coach loves seeing his offense operate at this level. Great passing out there.
Five straight baskets resulting from assists. They're playing as one unit out there.
McCollum against Westbrook. Outside Jones. Williamson with a screen on James. And Williamson throws it down.
We know CJ can score it, but the passing component of his game, I mean, McCollum's really upgraded it.
The Lakers have gone 4-4 in this third quarter. Perfect so far. Pass to James. From behind the arc. And they'll get another chance. And the shot goes in. Davis has got 6 points in the quarter.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
McCollum, the pass to Valanciunas. Shoots over Davis. Rebound collected by Anthony Davis. Davis has got his sixth rebound on the night. Pass to Westbrook. Now here's Walker. Fires the three. And that one comes off the assist by Westbrook. Westbrook's got six assists now in the game. The Pelicans have gotten 2 of 4 shots to go since the break. Time called here. The Pelicans decide to talk it over.
There's just a lot of wide open lanes to the rim here. That'll drive your coach nuts.
And, you know, I think he's going to tell him simply, we have to show more fight on the interior. That's the top priority right now.
3 minutes gone now in the third quarter. Now here's McCollum. 9 points in the game. Inside, down to five on the shot clock. And it's good. 2 points. Williamson's got 15.
Boy, he's really been dominant in this one. Unfortunately, he hasn't had much help.
Beverly outside. James finds Davis. Here's Westbrook. McCollum defends. Davis with a screen on McCollum. Westbrook, the pass to Davis. The 11-footer. Oh, a clear foul there on the missed shot. So he'll get a pair at the line.
Well, he is so tough to guard without fouling because he's aggressively attacking you at all times. And one of the great things about Westbrook, he's high motor all day, every day.
And that one falls for Westbrook. Alvarado's checked in for New Orleans. He makes one or two that time, and the play-in tournament has been a success. But some debate about whether the stats should count towards postseason stats. Granted, kind of falls in the abyss. How do you think we should reconcile?
Well, B.A., first of all, it is the postseason. It's exciting. Everyone's watching. So much is on the line. This is high-pressure elimination games. And yes, there have been some great performances that we've seen in the play-in tournament thus far. So I think these stats should be included in postseason numbers for players.
The Pelicans have gone 4 of 6 from the floor in this third quarter. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Physically, there's just no way to match up with Zion, especially now that he can go to the right hand.
And a chance to catch up on some numbers here. The scoring breakdown for the Lakers.
Well, you know, they've been tremendous, I think, when it comes to sharing the basketball. You know, getting guys involved on the plays and creating offensive opportunities for everybody. Equal opportunity offense is fun to watch.
And another thing that's impressed me has been their consistency with their two-point jump shots, getting it done from the mid-range.
And some changes here for the Lakers. Toscano Anderson, he's checked in for Walker, and Nunn is subbed in for Westbrook. Good on the second one. Los Angeles has gone 1 of 2 shooting from the perimeter since halftime. It's James on the wing, covered by Williamson. James passes to Beverly. Back to James. Takes a three. The Lakers with another miss.
And they've been able to maintain this lead despite his inconsistency from the field.
And he got the whistle on the way up. So he'll be headed to the line for a pair.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
And he drops a first.
They're finding a rhythm from the line as they try to cut into this deficit.
And the Lakers with some changes. Brown comes in for LeBron, and Reeves is subbed in for Beverly. That one's no good.
Oh, love the intensity in which they're hitting the boards.
Guys, that's been the key to their lead. I mean, simply put, the effort they've displayed on the glass has been the difference.
Nunn finds Brown. Davis, a screen. Down low. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take two from the free throw line.
That is textbook when you're talking a pump fake. Well executed that time by Davis. So good at knowing how to use that shot fake effectively.
That free throw, good from Davis. The Pelicans making a switch here. Nance has checked in. Both free throws, good from Davis. The Pelicans have gone 4 of 6 from the floor in this third quarter. Pass to Hayes. Here's Murphy. Here's Daniels. 6 points for him. Now Nance. Here's Daniels. And it's blocked by Davis. And they'll turn it over. Couldn't get the shot off. A shot clock violation. It's time to take a glance again at that superb block.
Amazing indeed. And getting stops like that only encourages them to keep attacking on the offensive end.
The Lakers have gone 6 for 9 in the half. Outside, Brown. Back to Nunn. Here's Reeves. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Davis misses. New Orleans' shooting has been excellent in the third quarter at 57%. And the Pelicans call time here. And as we head into this break, the players have an opportunity to replenish their energy with Gatorade as they prepare to go into the final stages of this ball game.
Absolutely. Over the course of a game, not to mention over the course of a season, you have to stay hydrated. If you don't, it's amazing how much slower your body is to bounce back. It can have a serious effect on performance, no question.
On defense, the Lakers. 13 points was their biggest lead of the game.
Not the best three-point shooter in the league, but he's got enough skill that you can't just let him fire it up.
Outside Nunn. Davis, a screen. And finished off by Davis.
Doesn't take a lot for AD to get to the rim. With his length, he can throw it down easily.
A minute 53 left in the third quarter. Pass to Hayes. Here's Daniels. He's got 6. Nance the screen to the inside. And out of bounds, Los Angeles will have it. The Lakers have gotten 7 of their first 11 attempts to go in this half. Here's Reeves, looking for his first basket still in this one. Davis, the pass to Nunn. Just 5 on the clock. No luck on that one. Nice D from Nance. Here's Alvarado. Nunn defends. Here's Daniels. Off the mark there with a 3. Los Angeles has gone 4 of 9 so far from the perimeter. Here's Reeves. Outside Nunn. 44 seconds left in the third. Pass to Davis. And Davis gets double teamed. Here's Toscano Anderson. With the clock winding down.
Well, Davis, so dominant, so strong, so athletic, so skilled. He got everything he wanted right there.
Here's Alvarado. He's got 5. Here's Daniels. Nance, the screen. Here's Daniels, the layup off target. Left side, Nunn. Pass to Davis. Over Nance. Off the mark with the outside fadeaway. And so it's Anthony Davis making things happen for the Los Angeles Lakers. On the glass, he was an absolute tyrant, just owning the boards. We'll be back in a moment. And it's time now to bring you our State Farm assist of the game.
Yeah, just shredding the defense with that feed. Zero chance to stop that.
Yeah, that's just a brilliant read of the defense. I mean, it was also excellent anticipation of the movement of his teammates before the pass. Just great harmony on all sides.
Well, there may not be a lot of drama down the stretch as we head into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Russell Westbrook out there with Kendrick Nunn. Then it's Juan Toscano-Anderson. Then there's LeBron James. And it's Gabriel in at the 5. That's who's in the game for the Lakers. The Lakers' shooting has been excellent so far, around 56%. Westbrook can't hit. New Orleans has gone 3 of 6 from deep so far. McCollum, the pass to Williamson. And Williamson throws it down.
Living up to the immense hype, Zion is putting on a show, shouldering the load offensively.
The Lakers in the lead. James with the ball. Inside. Here's Nunn. Jones with the block. Pass to Williamson. And here's McCollum. From 10 feet away, another score. His 5th make out of 10 tries.
Gotta love how McCollum hunts down his shots, always looking for his next bucket.
Westbrook outside. To the middle. Here's Gabriel. Dunks it hard with one hand. Wow, he makes it look easy.
Classic play that time by Westbrook, making space with the pick and roll to create for his team.
And just about a minute and a half gone by in the fourth. Now McCollum to the paint. It's tipped. Westbrook with it. He's picked up by Jones. And the ball is tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. pass to Valanciunas. 4-3. Rebounded by Gabriel. For Los Angeles, they've gotten just one shot to fall out of three attempts in the fourth. McCollum against Westbrook. They set the screen. Here's Gabriel. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. That's on Jonas Valanciunas. Down the first one. Walker, he's checked in for Los Angeles. Beverly comes in for Nunn. So he gets them both. The Pelicans have gotten half of their attempts to fall in the fourth. 2 for 4 now. Pass to McCollum. So it'll be 2 free throws. He was fouled in the act of shooting.
A late bloomer, CJ McCollum's career has been fun to watch unfold, and I'm sure inspired lots of hoopers out there.
Shooting two.
No good on that one. And the Lakers making a change here. Davis has checked in. He's good on the second. Time called here. Los Angeles decides to talk it over. And now let's present our New Balance player of the game, Anthony Davis.
An absolute monster in the paint. Simply overpowered the defender's attempts to slow him down. And that gave the offense high-quality shots and a lot of confidence.
And you know, this home arena really appreciates this guy. And it's clear that he takes pride in playing his best in front of them. And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
I had a chance to find out what Los Angeles' coach was going over with his guys. He said, quote, "This one isn't over. Those guys will come roaring back. We have to be ready. If something doesn't go our way, don't dwell. Just move on to the next play." Back to you.
All right, Allie, thanks once again. A touch under 2.5 minutes have passed now here in the fourth. Westbrook outside. Outside Walker. Left side Davis. And there's James from the arc. Valanciunas with a rebound. Valanciunas has got his eighth rebound here tonight. Jones against Walker. Jones, the pass to Williamson. Now here's McCollum. Defense right on him. Clock at six. Jones from outside. That's in. Coming off an assist from McCollum. McCollum's got his fourth assist with that last one. Los Angeles has gone 0 for 2 from outside here in the fourth quarter. James passes to Davis. And yep, it's good. Davis has got 14 points here in the second half.
Davis, a real mismatch inside because of his skill, size, and strength.
McCollum finds Ingram. Fourth quarter of play, and over 3.5 minutes have gone by now. Back to McCollum. This one for three. That's his sixth miss now, 5 of 11. The Lakers in the lead. Pass to Davis. Westbrook with it, defended by Jones. Westbrook against Jones. Westbrook can't hit. For New Orleans, they've got 3 of 6 shots to go in this fourth quarter. And here's McCollum. Shoots over Davis. And a foul called on the way up. So he'll take 2 from the free throw line. It's going to be on Anthony Davis.
And McCollum isn't afraid of contact, especially when he's being aggressive and looking to score.
Shooting 2.
First free throw is good. And he makes the first, but misses the second.
LeBron led the NBA in assists during his 2020 title season, with the Lakers becoming the second oldest player ever to lead the league in that category.
Pass to Williamson. It's stolen by James. Westbrook with it. Outside Walker. Now here's Davis. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Zion Williamson. That's his first foul of the game. Man, that assist title for LeBron. An incredible accomplishment for someone of his size, Clark.
I bet you didn't know this, B.A., or maybe you did, because you are a factoid machine. But the only player taller than LeBron to lead the league in assist, Wilt Chamberlain. When you throw in winning the bubble championship finals MVP, 2020 might have been LeBron's finest season.
Davis a screen. Walker passes to Davis. And finished off by Davis.
Good positioning that time from AD. Working the pick and roll beautifully.
New Orleans has gone 1 for 3 in the fourth quarter from range. McCollum, the pass to Ingram. Shoots over Walker, and that one's good. Ingram.
Sometimes it's simple. Put the ball in the hands of your scorers and let them do what they do best.
James against Williamson. Walker for 3. And the rebound goes to the Pelicans.
Hey, sometimes you miss even under the best of circumstances.
Takes a 13-footer. Kept alive. Valanciunas. And terrific work on the offensive glass as he picks up the deuce.
Yeah, he's a top-tier offensive rebounder. Valanciunas uses his size and strength to his advantage to do damage on the boards.
James passes to Davis. Misses off the left iron.
Well, that's a rare miss for him inside. He may have just rushed it a bit. Maybe lost concentration, too.
Pass to Jones. Now Williamson. And the layup is good off the glass. And now just a four-point Laker lead.
This is the guy Williamson wants to be for his team, the player they can count on in the clutch moments.
Davis with a screen on McCollum. Now James, covered by Williamson. James passes to Beverly. It's James on the wing. And so he draws the foul, headed to the line to shoot a pair.
Yeah, made for spots like this. It's the king at the line.
So the first one drops, and that puts him up five.
Hey, there are guys who have played as long as LeBron, okay? But how many have maintained their physical abilities the way he has so late in his career? I think that's a short list.
And so he drops them both, and it's a six-point ball game.
Every free throw is crucial in a close game. Nice work at the line.
Westbrook against McCollum. Valanciunas sets a screen. Shoot from the baseline. McCollum's shot is off. Los Angeles has gone 0 for 3 here in the fourth. Westbrook, the pass to James. Davis with a screen on Williamson. James against Williamson. Here's Davis. And again, the Lakers, no good.
It all comes down to this possession. They must get points.
It really does come down to this. I mean, come up empty, and it's over.
Valanciunas finds McCollum. And it's blocked by Davis.
Davis so good with his timing and length to get up and deny shots.
Good on the first, and that makes it a seven-point lead. And so both free throws good, and it's an eight-point ball game. New Orleans calls timeout. They're down by eight. 32 seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. All right, guys, what's your take?
They're going to have to get up a quick shot and then foul immediately.
Going to be hard, though. I mean, they don't have much time to work with here, but we've seen crazy stuff happen in this game.
Here's Ingram. Walker with a steal. Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. And Davis slams it home.
Their home crowd has energized them all game. Now they're closing it out.
And I think they can start that celebration right now. I mean, what a terrific team victory.
Here's New Orleans now.
And just not enough time for them to get back in this game.
Not by a long shot. It's all but official.
Jones from outside. Rebound collected by Anthony Davis. Now here's Westbrook. So we see the Lakers taking the W here. A competitive game. You have to feel like this crowd gave him a little extra edge.
Yeah, they really fed off the energy. You saw their activity level go up. Just a tremendous performance.
And now let's check in with Allie LaForce with the player of the game. Allie.
LeBron, that was an impressive win. What did it take to get it done tonight?
It's a really good team that we're playing. They're very resilient, just like us. They play together, they play hard, they play tough. So we had to bring that fight tonight.
You brought it, it paid off. Congrats.
Allie, thank you as always. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Allie LaForce, Clark Kellogg, and Grant Hill, this is Brian Anderson saying thank you for watching the NBA, brought to you by 2K Sports. We'll see you next time.